everyone. Welcome back to my channel, Your Florida Electrician. We have a level 2 EV charger here from EvGoer. I would like to do an unboxing on it. We'll do the install. Not going to go into detail, done lots of installs, but we definitely want to go through the features of this EV charger. This one they made is specifically for Tesla, a Tesla level 2 EV charger. We definitely want to investigate this, seeing that I have a Tesla. All right, let's unbox. All right, we have the instruction manual. There's some hardware, instruction manual, and this EV charger also has the RFID. And a nice long, I believe 25-foot charging cable. And our EvGoer charger, level 2. I want to get this out of the box and get it up on the wall. And this one is the hardwire kit. We're going to go ahead and hardwire this right now. Guys, when you first plug it in, this is the screen that you get. It says, please connect your car before you start charging. So let's bring the car over. Well, let's see if this works. Take it out. See if pushing the button works. Maybe I got to please connect your vehicle before you start charging. Okay. Okay, she's plugged in. And just like that, didn't need the card or anything. Let me see something. Wait. That stopped charging instantly. Let's try that again. What? So using the RFID card starts and stops immediately the charging. All right, now she's ramping up. Let me see if I can get a screenshot. 19 amps, 4.8 kilowatt, temperature 33°C. So this is apparently set for about 20 amps at the moment, but here's how much accumulated charge so far. 243 volts it's reading, 19 amps. All right, here's where we can change the amperage. Let's go ahead and push this. All right, 8 amp, 16 amp, 24 amp, 32, 40, 50. All right, let's bring this bad boy up to 50 and see what it does. Well, right now it's only at 4.8 kilowatt, 19 amps. Why?
What's going on? 20 amps. Oh.
20 amps. I can change it. I need to set it up to 50. See? Look at that. I put it up to 50, 48 amps. That's why it was being limited. Because I only had it set up to 20 amps in my car. So now look at 47. It's probably going to go to 48. I can't imagine it's going to go much higher than that. 11.3, so 47.3, and pretty good, 11.2 kilowatt. Let's see what the Tesla says, the Tesla app. Okay, Tesla app, 48 amps. It'll take 20 minutes to get it to my set, 80%. That's not long at all, man. That's good. It's working. Okay, now I want to get it to stop because I want to try some of these other features. Okay, RFID card, ready. Boom. It unlocked the charge port. I heard it. We got half a kilowatt. We're charging for about 1 minute. Let me see what some of these other features do. Let me check out this one. What did that do? Oh, I have to confirm. Oh, there's the time. Let's see. Does time. Okay, this is my delay time. Very simple. So if I want to charge 10 hours from now, there's 10. And then I go ahead and hit the check. Boom. It's going to start counting down. I want to start charging in 10 hours. Let's see. Let's wait for a minute, see what happens. Okay, so I get it. Very simple, not an app-driven EV charger. If you do not like using the cell phone, you don't have to use the cell phone. All you gotta do is plug it in. Use the RFID if you want to get it going and then forget about it. But she's going back up to 48 amps roughly. And we're connected over here. You can stop it by hitting the button, pulling it out, but it does not open the door. Let's see. Yep, let's see the car, what it says on the inside. Let's take a look. Oh, no music, please. I'll get in trouble. All right, 76%. Let's see, stop charging. So you do have to set your car. So fellas, if you do want a no-nonsense EV charger, doesn't use an app, you already have your Tesla app or whatever anyway. If you have a Tesla car, this one's geared for the Tesla car. It has the North American standard connector already with it. You don't need an adapter. You don't need a app. You just plug it in. If it's not already charging, you use your RFID card. Starts charging. You use your settings here for the amps. Why would you want to change the amps? Well, maybe you don't have a 200 amp panel or 150 amp panel. Maybe you only have 150, or maybe you only have 100 watts, 100 amp panel. Maybe you only want to charge with 20 watts. Lower charging speed is probably better for the battery anyway, but I'm testing it out. I'm doing 48 amps now until we get to 80%. You set all your settings in the car, your battery charge limit, delay start or whatever like that, but you don't have to. Just have it ready in the car. Set it up to your 80% in the car. And if you want to do a delay start, you can use the timer here. Each time you push it, adds another hour up to 12 hours and then hit the check mark. And then leave it plugged in and off she goes after 12 hours. Very simple, no nonsense. Easy to install. This one's a little bit more difficult because it is hardwired. It's not a plug-in. But a pretty good option. Definitely a pretty good option from EvGoer. I like it. I'm going to put a link to the tools that I use, a link to the EV charger here, a link to their website. And yeah, it's working fine. I'm going to be using this one. I think the cord is maybe 20 feet or 22 feet. It didn't seem like the full 25 feet, but that's okay. I mean, I don't normally park too far from the carport here anyway. And I mean, it's charging at 48 amps. The cord is not getting hot. And it has a neat little integral built-in, the holder for the charger. Kind of neat. Kind of holds it in there. But this came out good. Ended up being, had to get a strain relief connector in here, and it's charging pretty good. We'll let it charge up a little bit, let it do its thing. And let me go ahead and start making the video and start posting links for you guys. EvGoer, really appreciate it. I like the opportunity to be able to review. And IP66, yeah, it has all the safety. North American standard connector. Natural air cooling. This. Very simple. If you don't like using apps, get your EvGoer. You just turn it on and let it go. Let it forget it. You can shut it off and on with the car if you wanted to. Just tell it to stop charging. Leave it plugged in. Off you go. Thank you for joining me. Really appreciate you watching.